Thank you so much, Shayna, for being here with me. So my first question for you is, what drew you into Find Food Freedom and made me say, or made you say, I want to learn more?
I think just being in the rat race of diet culture was just had just become exhausting at that point. It had been so many years. And also the fact that like what I was trying to achieve, which was to have a smaller body, for it to get to just get to this place that didn't make sense for me. It was depressing and sad, and I think I was also just spending so much money on things that weren't giving me what I think I wanted. So that is when I started to explore like just the world of like what diet culture, what it does to us, especially for people who are in entertainment. And I just said, you know what, I don't want to be part of that, in that part of show business in general, just about changing your body and becoming something that pleases the industry.
Yeah. Do you feel like you had like one big aha moment that led you to your intuitive eating journey? Like, I'm gonna go pursue this, or do you feel like it was kind of like you just said, like a culmination of years of dieting, and then you said, I just can't do this anymore?
I feel like I needed to be ready to accept that this was the next journey. I feel like a lot of life changes that happened for me, and I'm not necessarily saying that this is how everybody needs to come to their aha moment, but you know, making the choice to be sober this year was definitely a huge breakthrough for me to make a lot of changes in my life in all aspects. But this was number one. This was the one thing that I thought, this has taken over my life. And now I have room to deal with it. I have the space to deal with it. Whereas before, I felt like I was numbing out with things like alcohol as well as food. I almost felt like the two kind of were, they worked together as partners, as little evil partners. you know, binge eating and drinking. It just kind of felt like when I was in that space, in that headspace, that I really didn't know what I wanted, what I was looking for, what was going to bring me happiness. So that was definitely, I think 70% of it is that I made that decision. Okay, I'm gonna get, not, you know, just for the people out there, I wasn't an alcoholic, but I was just someone that I felt like it could become a problem, that it could be something that I depended on in order to deal with all aspects of my life, and I didn't want that. So that for me was my aha moment.
Awesome. Thank you for sharing that. And so, how has your relationship with food transformed from the day we started to where you're at today? What has changed with your relationship with food?
I mean, it's drastically changed. Can I say that it's completely changed? No, I am undoing 20 plus years of like mental issues when it comes to food and body image. It's not gonna happen overnight, but I definitely feel like where I was when I started with you and where I am now is night and day. The fact that I can sit and eat a meal and I'm not counting anything and I'm not thinking about how many carbs are in something or how much fat is in something or whether or not I should be eating this or is this too much for myself. I just like literally, if I start to do that, I just stop myself and really listen and ask myself, what do I want? What do I need right now in order to feel at peace with what's happening in the moment? It's really forced me to just be in the moment and within my surroundings, the people that I'm with, and I was never able to do that. Every bite on the fork was always, there was a thought that went with it. Should I be doing this? Should I be having this? And it for me, it was the same mentality with the alcohol. I just kind of put the practices I did with making the decision to stop drinking because it was always, you know, I'll have one. Oh, should I have one more? Oh, come on, I'll just have one. You know, just that, it just took up so much of my time. And I felt that way with, I don't do that with food anymore now. It's just kind of like, I'm eating now because I'm hungry and that's good. And then I move on with my life.
That is amazing. A lot more mental bandwidth available for you,
Yes.
it sounds like.
Yeah.
This is a very broad question, but any big aha moments for you, or anything that really stands out on your food freedom journey that you were like, this was so important to me, or any pinnacle moments you want to share?
I would say going to the doctor and refusing to be weighed. You know, I had a physical done last week, and you know, it's the first thing they ask you to do is say, okay, come on, let's jump on the scale and weigh yourself. And, you know, it's now since I started Food Freedom, I've had to go to the doctor 4 times. There were some people who fought me on it. Not fought me, but they just were, they were just kind of like, oh, it's okay, you can turn around, or, you know, you don't have to tell, you know, because I'm like, I've done that before, and then I've seen the number. I've seen the screen or whatever it is. And then the last visit I did, they were like, okay, let's go jump on that scale. And I was like, actually, I'm not going to do that. And I said, I don't weigh myself anymore. I said, I haven't been on a scale in almost a year now. So, I'd even have them ask me, you know, do you want to take a guess? And I say, nope. And I said, no, because it doesn't tell you anything about my health. And then my report came back that my doctor said I had the best lipid panel in her entire office. So.
I love that.
Yeah.
I love that. And I think that just shows the testament of, like, you don't have to know somebody's weight to know their health.
Yeah.
And then you had that report card, if you will, of your lipid profile that showed some of the best markers of health, which.
Yeah. And my doctor afterwards, you know, because it's the nurse that comes in and does your vitals and blood pressure. The doctor came in and says, why didn't you want to weigh yourself? She's like, you look fine. Like, she made it out to be that I had an issue with looking at the number, and that she kind of made it like it shouldn't matter. And it doesn't. It's just like, listen, if I jump on the scale and it's whatever, it doesn't matter. Like, I feel great. My clothes they fit me fine. I go running every day, whatever. But still, like, it's just like, it's so ingrained in doctors that they have to say something, that it has to be part of the profile. When it doesn't, it's just such bullshit.
Yeah, I love that you pointed that out. And I think that's just a testament to the mental boundaries that you've learned to set to keep you safe. Because at the root of this is about protecting all the work that you've done thus far.
Yeah.
So if a friend came to you and said, Shayna, I want to work with Find Food Freedom, what would you say to them and why?
Run, don't walk. Because it'll be the last thing that you have to do. Like, honestly, like, that's it. Like, I think about all of the investment I put into my health with, you know, coaches and I'm not downing, like, the work. You know, there's been a lot of great things I've learned from the people through the years just about, I mean, I know a lot about nutrition, that's for sure. And I feel like there's a lot of people that I'm in company with that can say, I know a lot about nutrition. I know what makes me feel good. But it's the last stop on the journey, as far as I'm concerned. It's just like, it's a wrap. There's nothing else to talk about as far as I'm concerned after you do this program.
Thank you. Anything else you want to add, or anything I missed, to anybody that's thinking about, should I, you know, become an intuitive eater? Anything you think we didn't hit on?
What do you have to lose? I mean, all the other stuff, the thousands of, I mean, I don't know how many diets I've been on, 70? Of the 70, I've never come out of it being like, that was so great. I feel great about my life. Like, every time I've come out of it, I've said, I'm a failure. I feel like shit. I'm not good enough. It's just like, they have all this positive reinforcement. You're going to change your life. And it's just like, I never change. I changed my life for the worse after every single time. And like, I'm telling you that at the end of this, you change your life. It's impossible to not feel better about it. Even if your body changes in a way that, like, what you think is not good enough, it's just like, no, your body's telling you, I'm comfortable here. And it's okay. It's okay.